Hey, what's up, y'all? This is Edem with Global Abundance LLC, back with another video. On this channel, we talk all things real estate, commercial and residential, and we dive deep and we, you know, uncover what's working and what's not working. If you're new to the channel, go ahead and hit that like, share, and subscribe if you find value in this content. If you are already part of the family, welcome back. Thanks for checking in. Today's video is about expired listings. You know, maybe you are dealing with an expired listing right now. Maybe you have a listing that's coming up on expiration and it's not selling, it's not moving. You know, I want to help you out with a fast, fair, and a simple solution. So going to dive into, you know, how fast that process and how easy it can be for you. We have a free VIP group as well, where we also dive deep into different aspects of real estate, share what's working, what's not working, answer tough questions, and, you know, just learn and grow as a community together. I'll leave a link below in the description for that if you want to join. We'll love to have you. So let's get into today's content about expired listings. So before I get into expired listings, it brings me back to a video that I put out where I gave you, I'm giving you, because maybe you haven't seen that video, but it's basically the top questions that you want to ask a real estate agent that you're looking to work with. And the reason why that video is important is because of what we're talking about today, an expired listing. Maybe, you know, you got with the wrong real estate agent who really wasn't, suitable for your type of property in your local area. And, you know, they really don't have what it takes to move your type of property. So it ended up being expired. The best thing, obviously, is to avoid working with the wrong real estate agent if you are choosing to list your property. And, you know, avoid any of this happening anyway. You also avoid having to, you know, in certain cases, having to terminate the listing because, you know, some situation that you may have with the real estate agent. So make sure you ask those questions. Go back and watch that video if you want to. But I advise that you do so you have some questions and you're more informed about picking the right agent. So if you're a homeowner that wants to sell a house and you're dealing with an expired listing, you know, I know it can be incredibly frustrating right now. You put all this time and money into, you know, working with an agent only to find yourself back at square one, you know, months later. And, you know, if you want to sell, you probably have a good reason why you want to sell. So, you know, the house might be too big, you know, it might be too small, or, you know, it's not in the location that you really want anymore. Maybe you're, you know, dealing with, you know, something more difficult, like, you know, an inability to pay the mortgage, high property taxes, or problem tenants that, you know, you're tired of dealing with. When you just want to sell your house once and for all, but your listing expires, let's kind of get into some of the things you can do. One of the things you can do is list the property again. You know, if you have a listing that expired, you can always change things up and try it again. You can work with a new real estate agent who, you know, may have a different approach from the first one. Again, this is where that video where I gave you a set of questions to ask a real estate agent would come in really handy right here if you do choose to just work with another agent. You can hire a professional photographer who can help present your property in a new light. If you, you know, aren't against spending, you know, some money up front, you can make a few upgrades to the things that may have turned potential buyers off in the past. After, you know, waiting months for a buyer only to find yourself back at square one, doing it all again, you know, may not sound all that good, but again, luckily for you, there's some options out there. You can also rent it out. If you have an expired listing, you know, it may not be the right time for you to actually sell your house after all. Before you commit to another listing agreement, check out the rental market in your area. How much are properties like yours renting for? What do the vacancy rates look like? Is the area walkable or, you know, desired by renters? Not everyone wants to be a landlord. So, you know, only go with this option if it's something that you're able to handle and that you really even want to do. You can also hire a property management company to help you out if you want to go this route. They'll typically charge you somewhere around 10% of the monthly rent. Now, that percentage is going to vary by company and location of the property. So you can always rent out your property for a year or two if you don't need the cash right away. And then you can, you know, check out the real estate market down the road and hopefully have a better chance to sell at that time. And another thing you can do, which has a few benefits, is go ahead and try to sell your property with seller financing attached, you know, and carry the note. There's a lot of people out there who want to buy a home, but one blemish to their financial history is what's holding them back from a lot of opportunities. Maybe they've had identity fraud, which dropped their credit score. Maybe they were, you know, forced to use the money they have been saving up for a down payment on another emergency expense. These are generally great financially responsible people who would love the opportunity to become a homeowner. So by offering seller financing, you'll be able to sell your house for your asking price while also, you know, helping someone achieve their dream of finally owning a home. Now, this will work for you if, you know, you're a homeowner and you don't need the full amount of the sale up front. Okay. These agreements usually last for about 2 years, at which time, you know, the buyer should be able to qualify for a conventional loan, paying you for the property in full. A few more benefits with this is higher than average rent and the non-refundable down payment you get to keep. There's also a chance the buyer will, for whatever reason, you know, decide at the end of the term to just walk away, and you can then go ahead, wash, rinse, and repeat the whole process over. Another thing you can do is obviously just sell your property directly to a cash buyer. So when you're, you know, selling your house directly to a cash buyer, it's going to allow you to quickly sell your house without any further cost or, you know, time waiting around. You'll experience a straightforward and hassle-free selling experience that'll give you almost, you know, instant profits. The best thing is you won't have to pay any commissions or agent fees, which is going to eat away at the profits from a traditional sale. So working with the right cash buyer shouldn't cost you anything, and it will put money in your pocket immediately. Another thing you can do is just go ahead and play the waiting game. Okay. It may not be the answer that, you know, you're looking for, but sometimes it's best to just sit back and wait until the market improves in your area. The trouble with waiting is that, you know, you might be missing out on an opportunity that could be, you know, even bigger than what you have right now. So you might have to keep living in a house that doesn't match your needs or your lifestyle. And, you know, that isn't fun for anybody, of course. So if you have an expired listing, you can reach out to us and find out how we can help, or reach out to a trusted real estate investor that you know, to see what they can do for you. So these are, you know, some of the things that you want to keep in mind if you have an expired listing. And, you know, definitely make sure that, again, that you watch the video where I gave you questions to ask a real estate agent if you decide that you want to list a property again with another real estate agent, okay, and just pick off another new listing. Or maybe you have a property down the line and you want to be able to not get into a position where your listing ends up expired again. So I'll leave the video here with that. Hopefully you found some value. I'd love to hear from you. So go ahead and leave a comment below. Any questions, any feedback, any of your experiences, and let's have a conversation about it. So until next time, have a good one.